And now, here he is, the Emmy Award-winning Mr. Warmth himself, Don Rickles.
What's the matter with you, for Christ's sake? We gotta do a good job, goddammit. This is an important place to be a hit. I'll tell you this. You do good here, you get a wagon.
Don't piss me off, lady. Now, she's very stunning. She's looking at me going, oh, if you were younger.
I'll tell you this.
No, I'm kidding. I'm happily married, but go to a party.
I'll tell you this. You gotta understand, goddammit, this is an important job. This is the Warsaw Horsaw, Morsaw Horsaw Indians, whatever the hell they are, for Christ's name. They're out in the lobby now going, hey, 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 hey. Gotta kiss their ass so your family has a blanket, for Christ's name. 40 million jobs. We gotta work in a theater that's folding. No lobby, no nothing. The whole damn thing is on the rocks. And you stand there and you keep going with the band, for Christ's sake. Am I right or wrong?
Right.
You dumb son of a bitch. You're Polish, right?
Yeah.
See how I can't spot him? Bald and no brains. No, I'm kidding. The Polish people are great. You remember what you said in World War II? Retreat! I'll tell you that. Now, that's a joke. I was in World War II. I didn't see you, but I'll tell you this. Hey, lady, this is funny stuff. Everything I say on this stage, I did up in my room tonight, and I laughed my ass off. The whole goddamn, look at this, the whole front row, they put people from the home. From the home, they said, you spent the most money, you could sit in the front. Why are you standing there? Young Kippis over, sit down. He's Italian, yeah, he's got oil on his ass, and that's why they walk like that. It's not over, I know, lady. Just lay there. 40 million jobs, I gotta work in a place that's a failure. I'll tell you this. Understand people. That's what I do. I laugh about people, no matter what the hell they are. Irish, Jewish, Italian, Negro, Puerto Rican. Oh, Puerto Rican. I'll tell you this. Puerto Rican said to me in New York in an alley. I went, son of a bitch, I don't even know Maria. The whole goddamn thing. Gotta understand, that's a smart shirt, sir. With the checkered thing. Good luck to you, sir, really. Come in tomorrow night with some hay and a horse. Guy's wearing a checkered shirt like it's stunning, for Christ's sake. You gotta dress up. That's the theater. You gotta understand. People like this guy just sitting there waiting for his Mickey to die. I'll tell you this. Waiting for his Mickey to die, that's my best goddamn joke. I'll tell you this. But they don't understand. You gotta understand what people are. I swear to God, that's what I do. I laugh, I enjoy. Are you married, sir? Why? I'll tell you this. She's very pretty. I swear. Are you married, sir? You look like a horny guy, for crying out loud. You're not Jewish, are you? You are. Oh, perfect scene. I'll tell you this. You're a Jewish man in the front seat, of course. Now, how did the get right in the goddamn front? That's what God bless you, sir. No matter what you are. That's what I do. Irish, Jewish, Italian. It doesn't matter to me. It doesn't matter to me. And if there's a black guy around, worry. I'll tell you this. Look at this. The whole room, I can't find a black guy. They don't come here. They're laughing while they're at your house robbing you. Now, that's a joke. Whoa, your ass. That's a joke. I got a lot of great black Irish friends. What? Where? Right there? Where's the black gentleman? Oh, you can't see them in the dark. Oh, God bless you, sir. That's what I do. Some people say, that's crude, that's rude. That's not. Because you got to love people. You're a black man, there's no question about it. If you didn't, your ass fell into a bucket of M&Ms. I'll tell you this. What is your name, Leroy? What's your first name, sir? Lenny, my ass, Lenny. Lenny. They give themselves those kind of names so the cops can't find them. Lenny. I'll get it.
I didn't hear it fall.
You got better start looking for work. It's the whole goddamn, I kid you, Lenny. Be proud. You're a black man. I don't know how you got in here, but God bless you. Really. Is that your wife? Is that your wife, Lenny? Lenny, are you a mute, Lenny? The way things are today, it's tough enough being black, but it can be wary to a mute. Jesus, right. I spoke to Obama. You're going to get this seat next to you. Oh, God bless you, Lenny. Black man right in the front. Can't understand. Yeah. You play basketball? What do you do for a living, Lenny? Nothing? Black man. That's a black man. I do nothing, Mr. Riggles. I just sit around, watch them white men break their ass. That's all I do. Good luck to you, Lenny. At the end of the show, I want them hung. No, God forbid. Be proud. Be proud you're black. I'm a nice guy, in spite of what you heard. I'm a nice guy, you can bet your little bird. Whenever you see me, just don't stop to chat. I'm sorry, Tiny, can't help it if you're fat. I'm a nice guy, people all adore me. I'm a nice guy, psychiatrists explore me. I lie on their couch and they try not to bore me. A nice guy, that's me. I'm a nice guy, so put your mind at ease. A polite guy, lady, how about your knees? Love little kids and a stray cat and dog. But this group tonight is from Sears catalog. I'm a swell guy, the band thinks I'm groovy. But they're all high, you think they're out of movies. I only stay awake till you people approve me. A nice guy, that's me. See that, the black brother? We're born with it. I'm a bright guy, a mama, a very right guy. This room is just a toy. Nobody loves you till you scream and holler. But if I sang a boom, love you. I'm a great guy, and don't you forget it. Very straight guy, remember that I said it. Drop up and see me and I'll show you where it's at. Be sure it's not midnight when I turn into a bat. Remember when I bite your neck, I'm smiling like a cat. I'm a nice guy. I'm a great guy. I'm a nice guy. That's me. Give me a break.
Thank you, lady. One hooker remembered me. No, I'm kidding you. Thank you. What are you, a cat? Jesus Christ, I bust your ass for a lousy $100,000. And it's not the money. It's the love of you people. They all love me. Make a bet and we'll try it out. No, at my age, you can't do much, you know. Spider, he just sits in the pajamas, and when the wife gets one, he just comes out and goes. Then I say, Spider, action. He goes, no, 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 no. Sex isn't everything. I'm married 49 years. 49 years. Don't applaud, you never saw her. I'll tell you this. Nah, great lady, great. Jewish broad, you know, sits in a room with a dead herring on her ass. But I'll tell you this, dead herring on her ass. God damn it, lady, you're starting to steam me. I'm telling you that right now. You're Italian, right? What is your heritage, Johnny? Croatian? Son of a bitch, I don't have a joke for that. Croatian, God bless you. Dobra, Dobrigenia, Cevapcici. 2 years in Yugoslavia doing a picture called Kelly's Heroes. Zagreb, I was there, Zagreb. Then I was in the capital. It was all over the place, and everybody did the same thing. Gave me the meal, and I had the runs 24 hours a day. No, they're wonderful people. Every place we worked, they burned down. But I'll tell you this. It's a lot of years ago. Kelly's here, really. I know your country. It's okay. We used to go to Trieste to get broads and laughs. Anyway, I was single then, you know. I was so single, I was in heat for a moose, for Christ's sake. I'm going to try to stand up. If I fall on my ass, the first Nazi that laughs, I'm going to get his name. No, I got nothing against the Germans. 2.5 years in the Navy. And all I remember in the jungle was the Japanese guys going, oh, Mr. Rickles, your shirts are ready. I'll tell you this. Oh my God. I'm married now, what, 29? 49, Jesus, 29. 49 years I'm married. Yeah, well, you didn't see it. I'll tell you this. I said that before, but I like to hear it. I'll tell you this. 49 years married. It's not easy, and it's not all the big pop. Everybody says, oh, the sex. It's not that. It really isn't. Oh, I'll tell you this. I'm married to one. How long are you married, dear? You single? Want to go to a party? She's very pretty. And this is your boyfriend? Yeah, he looks 90. I guess when you make love, he spits up. No, I'm kidding you, Dad. God bless. I call him Dad. What are you, about 50?
Yeah, 53.
On the left side of his ass, he's 53. No, 53. He's a young man yet. God bless. You got to enjoy. I'm married. What's your first name, sir?
Greg.
Greg, I make it up. You got to make it horny. Last night, I was a barge going up the Mississippi. You know what I mean? She lays at the end of the bed in a nude. And I'm the barge. And I go, barge coming up the Mississippi. Boom. 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 And she's the dock. Boom. And she lays there, hit the dock. Hit the dock. Boom. 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 Oh, you got to make it exciting now, I swear to God. You, this guy looks great. You look like General Custer's son, for Christ's sake. I said that, and 4 Indians in the back went, hey, what, hey, hey, hey. You got to kiss the Indians' asses, boy. Yeah, great. So on the boardwalk in Atlantic City. Who wants beads? 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 They kissed their ass. Who needs the Indians? Except they attack your fort. Anyway, that's the whole damn thing. What's your name, son, with the glasses that can't see me? What?
Anthony.
You're Italian, right? What are you, Anthony?
Spanish.
What, that's better? I'll tell you that. Where's your family from, originally? Mexico. See all the flies around them? No, that's a joke, son. That's a joke. Is that your dad? Some old pain in the ass that don't want to laugh, right? Are you Mexican also, sir? What is your heritage? Polish. Oh, Jesus Christ. A Mexican and a Polish. Can you imagine if we're attacked and they're in charge? Wear a gun. God bless you, sir. Be proud. I make fun of people. Why not? Because I make a lot of goddamn money. I'll tell you this. It's not a rodeo. Try to walk around.
Don't have dinner here.
I swear to God. My wife and I just came back from Mexico City. I swear to God. Had a taco and she kept walking around going, son of a bitch, I think it's the tomatoes. No, it was the tacos, the goddamn tacos. Jesus Christ. No, you eat in Mexico, you keep sitting around the house going, who is that? Is that me? Who is that? You laugh and enjoy. You're the guy with the hat. It's not young Kipper. Take the hat off. Right? You're an Irishman, right? Sir, with the hat, with the cap? Are you a mute? God damn it, are you a mute? Jesus Christ, you ask a guy a question. Are you Irish, sir? You Irish? No, the guy with the white shirt here. You Irish? What is your heritage, sir? English? Oh, kiss my muffin. Anyway, my man, daddy's home. Anyway, the English are good people, really. During the war, they kept saying, don't attack, run. Now I make fun of the English. I was in London a lot of times. Got my ears shot off, but they kept saying, we'll win, don't worry, we'll win. You gotta understand, I gotta sit down now. Before, I didn't fall. No, see, that's what happens. You stagger with this goddamn disease. I'll tell you what this is. This is called Mama Fujiitis, or whatever the hell it is. It's a poison that got into my leg. I swear to God. Started out as a little pimple, and then the goddamn thing became swollen, blah, 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 and I was operated on six times to make me come out here to act for this dumb Polish guy right here. Six times, but any of you, whether it be, God forbid, cancer, whatever it is, you gotta fight what you got. Because God says, hey, if you fight, you got a chance. And this leg. Huh? Yeah, so. My biggest dream is I worked for the President of the United States. Ronald Reagan was a good friend to me. I'll never forget that I worked at the White House and Billy Graham was there. Bunch of guys on motorcycles in the back. Anyway, and I swear to God, Ronald Reagan was great. We had so many laughs together. He didn't look for broads. All he looked for is to see how his pants looked. Anyway, it's a long story, but life is good when you meet the biggest people in the world. And as I sit here tonight, I'm the biggest. No. No, yeah, your ass. I'm not the biggest, you're kidding. I'm here as a mercy visitor. I'll tell you this, I could have been in 40 million towns. I drove 17 miles in darkness to reach this cockamamie kazoo place. It's going to fall on its ass pretty soon. But that's not the truth. They're great people. And you said, you're great. This guy's like, you got to be a German guy. This guy never lives. He's sitting there like this. The Jews are going to die. He's got that attitude. That's like, Unsteirenites in your eye. I was in Germany, and they all go like this. You want soup, or do you want the meat? And he had a gun. But that's not the truth. No, I laugh about it. Yeah. I was all over Europe. And all you Catholics, be proud. I went to the Vatican.
And we had a good friend, the Monsignor, arranged for me and my wife to visit. He hopes quarters, his clothing, everything. He was at the beach. He was right. No, they go to the beach. They have done it. And we were in the quarters. And there was and we sat around. And you could hear that. It was God humming. And then I sat there and I said, wow, this is great, Barbara. We're in the Vatican. And then we met the other pope. The first time we met, the man that passed away, rest his soul. He was an old man. And he came out on the balcony and he went, and all the Catholics went, huh? But today you have a new pope. He comes out and says, and he's half German. Und Steinmann Heights and Weinlein. Look at that, the Catholic went, No matter what your faith is, Irish, Jewish, Italian, Negro, Puerto Rican. Well, Puerto Rican, I'll tell you this. Puerto Rican said to me in New York in an alley, I went, son of a bitch. That's the thing. I said that before, but I love what I do. Always remember. Always remember what you are. Enjoy, I tell you the truth. I look down and I see all these people. Nobody here has any money. You are correct. The hooker recognizes. That's what I got to understand. People. And trust them, really. I have a lot of friends in life. I look around this room and I don't see one. Yeah. There. Is that your wife, sir? No, the guy with the checkered cowboy outfit. Is that your wife? Your girlfriend? Ooh. I'll tell you this. No, I'm kidding. She's very pretty. Ooh, Jesus. What was it, a bus? No, you're very pretty. What do you do for a living, dear? What do you do? Work in a bank. Kiss my change. He's very pretty. Good luck to you. And I can see he's in heat again. Take off the glasses tonight and try to hit the right target. Anyway, see, when you make love, you've got to be like the Jews. We circle the bed and get an estimate. To one of you, to your health, and to mine, l'chaim. To those of you, Spirito Santo, Duranto, Duranto, look at that. The Gentile guy went, you better duck, your shirts will go bad. Jesus Christ. I love the Japanese people. You gotta, I don't know why we went to war with them. We've got to kiss their ass. Otherwise, my grandchildren have no toys. What, are you going to vote and ask him if that's funny? Look at this. This woman went, what do you think, Harry? I don't know. Jesus Christ. I'm sitting in the front. I don't know a goddamn thing. I'm just lucky I'm sitting there. Be like the Pollock. He's sitting there going, ha, 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 ha. I call you Pollock. That's not nice. Polish. What do you do for a living? You're in sales? Anyway, my father was a salesman. Yeah. As soon as he got to the closing, he blew it. Couldn't handle anything. That's the main thing, I swear to God. You gotta know how much people can handle. What's your name, son? You right there. Yeah, Chris. Yeah. What?
Chris.
Come here a minute, Chris. Hurry up. Hurry up! Come up on the stairs, Chris. Hurry up. Don't look at them. They don't know what the hell's going on. Hurry up. Oh, you're a tall, handsome-looking guy.
Pleasure.
Want to chip in and get you a jacket?
Yeah.
No, you don't need it. You look great. I'm going to face this way. You can lean down. That's okay. What, are you going to the toilet? No. Yeah. No, that's all right. You're a good guy. You don't mind my kidding around with you, do you?
No, sir.
Oh, good. You don't have to call me sir. King of Jews. What's your last name, Chris?
Seigen.
Seigen.
Yes, sir.
What is your heritage?
Polish.
Oh. I get the Polish people.
I quite bet.
Would you like to convert to something else?
Yes.
No, be proud of you. Be proud of you, Peter. What do you do for a living?
I work in computers.
Oh, a Polish guy with a brain. You don't mind my kidding around, do you?
No.
Okay. You're going to help me. You really are. As I look around, I swear to God, I see people here that are so old, it's ridiculous. But I look and I say, what's your name, son? Yo, right behind the guy with the white shirt. Yo. Yes, yo, yo. Yes, that's right. Yo.
Brenda.
No, that guy, not you, lady. Come here. Yo, that's right. Yo, hurry up. The guy, not the lady. Oh, there he is. God bless you. There's a new thing out called a diet. Get over here. How long you been prancing around like that? No, I'm kidding. You're not a queer, are you?
No, sir.
Okay. I'm kidding. I don't care. What's your name?
Jesus.
You're Italian.
No. I'm Mexican American.
What, that's better?
Well.
No, I'll be proud, Mexican. We need the Mexican people.
Absolutely.
Okay? These shoes. I kid you, people. Without the Mexicans, this would be a great country. No. That's a joke. Could you let go of my hand?
Oh.
Get a cloth and wash this.
Okay. No,
sit down. Get over here. Yes. You don't mind my getting around.
Oh, absolutely not. Yeah.
Wait, what's your name? Come over here.
Okay.
Jesus, what?
Limon.
Limon.
Yeah.
Get immigration on the phone. Anyway, what did you do for a living, Limon?
I fix computers and I'm an actor.
Oh!
Yeah.
This is a big chance for you. Look at that smile. God bless you. You got children?
No kids.
There's a new book out. See, you got to stand in the hall, then take Spider out of there. You take him out of the pajamas, you don't look around. And you blow the whistle and you go, boom! And you have a kid.
There you go.
Now, we're going to be Japanese soldiers, okay?
Okay.
And you, you're Polish, you'll get the better part. Okay. You'll be, what's your first name again?
Chris,
you'll be General Takatara.
General.
Yeah, okay. First, I talk in English. Louder, get a better seat. I'm kidding, lady. God bless you. Can you hear me now? 40 million Jews. I got to hit a loud broad yet. All right. You're going to be General Takasagama.
Okay.
And I'm going to be Captain Konumura. And you're going to be Corporal Tuna. And we're on Guam. First I speak, okay? All right. Get our hands together. Okay. Hands. Okay, then stick on our teeth like Japanese soldiers. I start. Momoyoko! Mokoyetsagama! Come on! So I I'll tell you when, for Christ's sake. Tokusuyama. Tokusuyama. Mama. I never had anybody do it right. Nikinama Sada. Oh yeah. Sagada, we bow. Oh, Sayamayama. Now we talk in Japanese. Nikinima Utoyama Sada. In Japanese, goddammit, in Japanese. Well, I'll tell you when.
Okay.
Nikinama Toshiba Kamena.
Nikiuma Nashinomaya.
Make up your own Japanese, goddammit. Nikita Mara Tutsutsu!
Hey, what's it?
This guy's a real jack.
Thanks, guys, for being good sports. Give a nice. Thank you so much. Give a nice hand. Nice hand. You wouldn't want your ass up here. Give him a nice hand. Where was that gentleman? Right in here. What was he? Where is he? The gentleman I just had on the stage. I can't see with these lights. Oh, yeah. What was your first name again?
Chris.
What do you drink, Chris?
Jack and Coke.
Good. Good drink. Anyway, give Chris, we're not allowed to give out booze, but give him a wonderful picture. Yours truly, you can either put it on the wall or on the toilet. It's up to you. But it'll be for you for being a good sport, really. Give him a nice one. And give my Mexican friend a picture of this man getting a gift from him. I'll give him a picture, too. These gentlemen are very nice. God bless. Give a nice day. Yeah. Boy, this is... I haven't been in this area in a long time. And why not? It's always dark and rocks. And rocks and a lot of dirt. And nothing happens. These are the two guys that live here. Oh, Arizona, boy. Had some times here. It was all little joints in those days, boy. Yeah, and everybody used to walk around sucking sand. But I had a good time because I always had a good attitude, like I have with you people. It's a pleasure for me with a bum leg right now, but it'll get better. And I don't look for mercy, but I am so delighted when I can stand in front of nice people and have a bad leg and know I'm going to get a ton of money. I'm married 49 years. And you never saw her. 49 years. You know. And she always gets horny about 4 in the morning. She starts that crap. Pussycat. Pussycat. And I got to get my ass under the bed and go, meow. Meow. But you do it because everything's in her name. What the hell are you, Count Basie? That was the Basie theme, right? You just made that up? Let me ask you this. Was that worth losing your job? When you get tired of laughing, let me know. Is that the song? Huh? Can I tell you? It's really a joy. Really, you guys. I'll trade you laughter for love. I'll trade you one for the other. Laughter for love. What can you lose? Some madness for mirth. And for whatever it's worth. Whether you like it or not, I'll give you all that I've got. I'll trade you sunlight for gold. One shines as bright as the other. Love is pure gold. Laughter the sun. Light.
this is my life. For all of my life. And you are part of this life I live. I swear that it's true. I love to do what I do. To share this laughter I give. For just a little love from you.
Thank you so much. You really enjoy, you really are. You know, I look back at my career and gee, I'm 88 years young. And had I said 89, I would have got a bigger hand. I dreamed when I was a very young man, would I ever last this long? Because I used to do what I do now. And I said, he insults people. Get this guy out of here. My mother used to wait in the car and drive me home. It wasn't easy. But I always believed being different. And I met a man, rest his soul, that was a great friend to me. You heard stories about him, but he was a great man. His name was Frank Sinatra. And Mr. Sinatra saw me in a little club in Miami Beach. Well, it's a story before that. My mother was like sort of a, rest of soul, was sort of a Jew Patton, you know. Very strong. You'd say, hello, Etta. That was her name, Etta. Hello, Etta. How are you, darling? How are you? You know, oh, Jesus. She was great. I'm an only child. And she made sure I got up in the morning and did exactly what I was told. But she was great. She was great. And one day we were in Florida, and I was working in a little club, and Frank was starring at the Fountain Blue. And my mother said, I'm going to go up and see Dolly. That was Frank's mom. And I'm going to ask him if he'd come and see you. I said, Ma, stop it. Don't. Will you keep quiet? Fast forward. There she was in Sinatra's suite with Dolly. She said, Dolly, darling, would you, that's where my mother was, Dolly, darling, would you help my Donnie? She called me Donnie. Help my Donnie get Frank to come and see him. Done, Etta, done. That was her name, Etta. Done, Etta. Done, done, done. A couple of nights later, in walks Frank with all his friends. All scientists. He sat down in the front and said, help me God. I said, Frank, be yourself. Stand up and hit somebody. And thank God he laughed. Had he not laughed, I would have been on the Jerry Lewis telethon. Walk on, with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. Frank was great to me. I was single then. Always looking for a girl, a monkey, a dog. I was 35 years old and never married. Had a lot of problems. I used to sit in the tub and make it bubble. And Frank introduced me to this one girl, hot chick girl, never forget it. Name was Margie. Kind of pretty, glasses, little space in the front teeth. And every time we made love, she started a whistle. I didn't know if I stooped her or made tea. Ever since I told that joke to Frank, I can't find my aunt in the Bronx. And now a few moments of a man I adored. Francis, you're on.
Spider, what's your name?
I'm a nice guy. Whenever you see me, just don't stop the chat. I'm sorry, lady, I can't help it if you're found. all recognize you, old timer.
Here, you take this for a half hour. Don't walk around with a lollipop.
Don't do that with
a
microphone.
It's only microphones. They can afford it, Frank. What are you worried about? You're rich. You'll get moody and buy the whole place. Listen, Frank, I thank you for coming, and I love you. I really do. And the applause proved it, Dave, really.
They'd applaud anybody who could get you to stop singing. That's what they were really saying. Sing better, a little better than a lot of big names I've known.
All right, you said it. You hear it? Frank Sinatra endorsed me that I sing great. You heard it, that I sing better than some of the big names. You folks heard it right here. Thanks, Frank.
Howard Cosell? Richard Harris? Fritz the Cat?
Frank, don't. Please, you put me in the dump. I need this, Frank. I need a shot. Please, I know you love me. Down deep in your heart, with all the nonsense, I know you love me.
Wrong.
Oh, Frank, I don't know with you. I go to all the Italian restaurants. I go and eat that food, and I enjoy. I go, den da 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 den. I do that all for you, Frank. I don't even like the tunes. I buy ice from your people when Gino Manganzo calls me. Marco Papanazzi, Vitati Tontanenti, Tontoni Tontananzi.
Yeah,
they all call me.
But they're all Irish. What do you grow up
for? Isn't he great, Father? Now, but Frank's, Frank's?
Frank.
Listen, Frank. Do me a favor. Give me a break. I got relatives living in Jersey.
Not really. For long.
He, Mr. Soul, was a great man, and I had many wonderful times with him, and I haven't got one album. But I got just one album.
We better go back to the slides.
Rest easy, Francis. Rest easy. You hear those drums? They mean a lot to me. I grew up in a place called Jackson Heights, Long Island. And the old hooker remembers me. And Jackson Heights, which is now known as Mondovi. But Jackson Heights was something in those days. Now you need a spear and a good jungle guide. But it was fun days. And I grew up there, and in that town there was a doctor named Dr. James Cagney. He was a dentist, and he had an office in Jackson Heights. And my father always knew that I wanted to rest his soul, that I always wanted to be an actor. He said, Don, I'm going to introduce you to Mr. Cagney. Yeah, don't make a thing. Just keep quiet. Follow me. Fast forward, there I was in James Cagney's office. And in front of me stood this dynamite of a man, his brother Jim. And the doctor said, talk to my brother. And my father said, tell him. I said, Mr. Cagney. He said, don't, Sonny. Sonny, don't call me Mr. Cagney. Just say, Jimmy, what's on your mind, son? I said, sir, I really want to be an actor. I sure you do, kid. It's tough, tough, tough. Rejection, rejection, and more rejection. Can you handle it? Well, Jim, don't well me, sonny boy. You got to get in there and hope you get lucky. And hope someday you'll be on the stage and be making some bucks. It's not easy, sonny. Jimmy, I made it. I'm here in Arizona at a theater that's collapsing. But Jim did a number that told the whole story about our young boys and girls that are still overseas protecting this gathering and many more. And Jim did a number that went something like this. To you, Jimmy. To you, Jimmy. I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. Yankee Doodle do or die. Real life nephew of my Uncle Sam. Born on the 4th of July. She's
My Yankee Doodle sweet.
My Yankee Doodle boy.
Yankee Doodle went to London just to ride the pony. I am that Yankee boy. I am that Yankee boy. I am that Yankee boy.
Jimmy, watch over those boys and girls. Bring them home soon, Jim. Bring them home soon, Jimmy. I love you, Jimmy. I love you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Get the names of those that didn't stand. Just yell out, it's an open forum.
No doctors! No doctors!
What did he say for me?
Oh. Excuse me. Can I have a drink? This is better. Thanks so much. That's why you got those seats. No, God bless you, sir. Thanks so much. That's right. I was in the Navy. I don't know if any of you guys in the Navy. I was in the Navy in World War II, and I was on a ship called the USS Cyrene, and I said, I'm an actor, I do jokes, and I'm a comedy star, and in my mind, and I said, and I'm great. But they said, keep firing. That's the truth. I was on Cebu in the Philippine Islands. And I said, why are they shooting? Why are they shooting? We got to kiss their ass someday. We need these guys to make toys for our kids. But I learned a lot. 18 years old, can you imagine? 18 years old. And there I was on a ship with a 20 millimeter gun. Bum, 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 bum. And my commanding officer, Sam Castaldo, I'll never forget it. How about that? A lieutenant. He said, Don, do you know what you're shooting at? I said, no, but fun. And I did that, and he went, don't be a wise guy. Thank you so much. I have other work for you, too. What do we have? You know, you're all blessed with friends. Bob Newhart, God love him, is my dearest friend. He'll be here, by the way. It's fun to be with Bob. We travel the world together with our wives. And being alone with Bob is like being on an island that's not catching on. I'm a loud Jewish kid from New York, and he's a Gentile boy from the Midwest that goes, Anyway, but he's brilliant. He went to Chicago University, and I went to high school in Jackson Heights, Long Island. And somebody put a girl's ass on top of a police car. Write that down. That's a good joke. And Bob was in the Army, and we became great friends. Here we are, two American boys raised in two different societies. He was an accountant, and I was a dumbbell. I went to Newtown High School and majored in the gymnasium. And we became great friends and traveled the world together. It's always maintained that now we have grandchildren and what have you, and it's difficult to travel. So we go over to Bob's house on Christmas and pretend we love Jesus. Anyway, Well, they always do that, you know. About, and I love when we always go to Mass. I did. I go with Bob, God bless him, when we have to. I love when the Monsignor comes out and goes, Spirito Santo, Taranto, it's Levanto, Spanto. And I found out what that means. To the Jews, I mean, the highway's blocked, take the other road. I told that to the Monsignor. We were inside the Vatican. We really were. We really were. And it was so great that the Holy Father wasn't there. He was at the beach. Yeah, they left. They go to the beach. They have a private beach. They could. Anyway, we had some great times in Rome. We really did. And the Lord always said, don't kid around. You know, the German people, they'll arrest us. I said, Bob, trust me. In the middle of Munich, midday, we're shopping. The wives are shopping. We're watching. And I said, Bob, we just got to relax. And he said, Jesus Christ, don't walk like that, for God's sake. I said, why? Why? I'm my legs hurt. I did stuff like that, and he still loves me, and I love him. And so it was. Huh? I don't know what that means. To all of you, health, that's an important thing. To all of you. So if you walk through those doors tonight and you enjoyed everything I said, or had any animosity towards it, I say from my heart, please believe it's done with love and respect. And do yourself a favor. Don't fly Ozark Airlines. Every performer, big or small, needs an audience. Why are you playing? What are you? What the hell are you, Count Basie, for Christ's sake? I do. Jesus, I don't care what I do. So lonely. Yeah. And I've met all the big stars and I've become friends. Dean Martin, rest his soul, was a great friend of mine. He was at my wedding when he married the 9-year-old. His wedding. His wedding. And then there was the great man. He's doing it my way. And Frank was there. It was so great. Everybody showed up. Vinny Bombini. Ginny Garbarelli. And they were all there. Their guns oiled and ready to open fire. That was great. And I used to sit down with them. And I thought it was my clothes. It was them. Gunpowder smell all over me, for Christ's sake. Yeah. But I tell you, to know those guys, hey, they did wrong, but they did good things too. And Frank, wherever you are, come back and help me, Frank. And don't forget them, because they're always in my heart. And I'm sure when you listen to his music, you'll know. That's Sinatra and Dean and Sammy are still around. Okay, no one, come on. Enjoy life. And to you, my friends, enjoy life as long as you live. Remember, be what I've had and what I wish you have. Have people around you who care. Thank you so much. I'll just take a few moments of your time. Please be seated, and Father Johnson will speak to you later. Anyway, you've been so swell. I mean that. It's a long time since it's three years ago that I was here last, and you made my heart feel warm, and I thank you for that, especially with my nerves being a funny leg. I said, bum leg like this. I said, oh God, I gotta work. And thank God you give me the courage to keep going with a bum leg, and I appreciate it. I'd like you to know that at my side here has been with me for quite a while now, and he's wonderful. He's with Tommy Dorsey, he was with all the biggies, he was with Sinatra for many years, and he's a good friend, Mr. Vincent Falcone. Mr. Vincent. We have an album out, a DVD out called Mr. Warmth, if you haven't seen it. It's thank you. It won two Emmys, one for yours truly, and well, not to get too dramatic, but I feel that. And my dear son Larry, who God unfortunately decided he had to leave us, and rest his soul, I think of him all the time. But he gave me a beautiful daughter and two grandchildren. But Larry won an Emmy with me, along with Mr. Warmth, the DVD. This is a Toy Story 4. I just was notified today. We'll come out again, and I'll play Mr. Potato Head. So, a nice hand for a great group of guys that you love, Lady Office. December 1st, if you're not busy with preparing for the wonderful holiday Christmas, I'll be on with Jimmy Kimmel, his wonderful show. Jimmy's a good friend. Every time I'm on, he does what he's told. And then I'll be on with Dave on his last goodbye on television. And some of these wonderful artists are gone, but I'm going to still keep going whether they like it or not. I don't care. This is my fourth time, I believe, at the Wild Horse Casino. And I want to say that to all the staff and all the folks that have been here, they've treated my wife and I and my little operation with great class and warmth, and I thank them. And I just want to say to you, never forget your... Oh, yeah. I have a dear lady that I think you'd like to meet, and she's gone now, but if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't be sitting here, Kane or no Kane. And it was my mother. A few minutes with Etta Rickles, my mother.
Mrs. Etta Rickles.
Hello, doll boy. From the time we would use my knitting needles to conduct the orchestra at Radio City Music Hall, I never doubted that you would be a great entertainer. I wish I could be with you tonight and serve this delicious chopped liver I just made for you and all your friends. But anyway, eat and be happy. I am with you in spirit tonight. I am so proud of you, not just my son, the comedian, but I'm even more proud of you, my son, the kind, honest human being.
Thank you, Mom. May God give you a good place to live, and as long as you live.
I am what I am. I am my own special creation. So come take a look, give me the hook or an ovation. It's my world, and I want to have a little pride in my
world, and it's not a place you have to hide in. Oh, ice, not worth a damn, till you can say, hey world, I am what I am. I am what I am, and what I am needs no excuses. I deal my own deck, sometimes the ace, sometimes the deuces. And so, what if I bank a little fun on people? Why not? That's exactly what this world is after. Life's not worth a damn till you can say, hey world, I am.
God bless.